strong. I'm mighty happy to be here tonight, and I want to congratulate your Board of Education and your community and what you did in naming this stadium for John Muth. I can think of no one who would deserve an honor like this as much as John Muth, because he was a coach here for some 12 years. And every man that he worked with, every player that he worked with is a better man for having played with John Muth. And on top of that, he was also the principal of your high school for many, many years. And in that capacity and position, he helped so many of the students of this community. As a matter of fact, you would have to look a long, long way to find anyone who has contributed more to his community than John Muth. And that's why I'm here tonight, is to respect and pay honor to him. To give you a little idea how long we go over here, he started coaching here 60 years ago this fall. I came here 49 years ago this fall as his assistant. So you'll see what a long period of time, but the things that he has done then and in the time since, still live with people because he indoctrinated us in the right things. I might just say a word to you football players tonight. I think it's wonderful you come here and gather around and be a part of this. And I hope you'll remember this momentous occasion for John Muth. But I want to say something more of a more practical nature. Now you've been here off your feet, you are exercising and getting in shape and sweat. Now you've been down here for 15 or 20 minutes. You better make doggone sure you get going again before the ball game. There's one thing that I did in sports better than anybody else. Better than anybody else. As long as I coached, and that was about 45 years, I never had a critical injury. And one of the reasons we avoided was going to do just for you to get up and get warmed up before you go into that ball game. Get warmed up before you get into it. Because we always have. With practice, we used to call off the last play. Because I've studied a lot of situations where you got a bad injury on the last play. So I let them run the scrimmage around, and then I blow the whistle and say, on in, on in. To avoid that last injury. But if you stay in shape and get in shape, and let me show you something I am a great believer in. Doug, you come up here a minute, will you please? I'm a believer in this. And you get down on all fours. On all fours and face me. Not them, me.
Now who's going to hold this? Why don't you all come up and hold this?
Oh.
Come on now, don't be so lazy. All right. But I believe this very seriously. That every practice...
Now make your neck stiff and keep that head high. Now, let me pull. All right, now, let me push on. Make a step. High, high, high. All right, now the other way. Right, hard. And now, under your chin. Let me lift you up. All right. Now, you should do that in every practice at least twice. That's the most important exercise of all. Because about as bad an injury as you can get is what they call a brain stem injury in the back of your neck. But if you build that neck up so you have a full neck, you know, old Reese, the sports writer, asked me one time, said, do you think girls ought to play football? And I said, heck no. Because to play football, you ought to have a full neck. And who wants to see a girl with a full neck? We've been twice every practice, and we never got a serious injury with the neck or the brain stem. Never. So I mention that because it's just unpractical. Because football is a great, great team, and you'll carry it with you forever. And the things you get from it are this. In football, when you get knocked down, what do? You get up. You get up and go again. You catch it, dude. You get up and go. All right, number two, you go back to the huddle, and you all get the same play, and you run the same play together. You'll get to be too many people in this country. Too many people are going on the left and the right and all that stuff, and helping this group and helping that one. They had a statement say the other day, he said, I'm not interested in the right and the left. I'm interested in up or down. He said, we're going to go up. And that's what every good football team learns. That they learn to go up by going to the huddle and getting the same play and running it together. Together, together. And the third one is, in football, there's nothing comes easy. There's nothing worth a dime that comes easy. As a matter of fact, I never saw a football player make a tackle with a smile on his face. There's nothing easy about it. And that's why it's the greatest game of all, by far. Is that an easy game where they kick the silly ball around and all that? The better game is a tougher game. And that's why I want to congratulate you fellas for being here. And that's why I want to congratulate your community for having football for over 50 years, because it's a tough game, it's a demanding game, and it takes character to play it. Congratulations, and may you have a great game here tonight. And to my great, great friend, John Muth, I can't tell you how happy I am to be here for your great honor. Thank you very much.
Right.
national anthem is playing at the Mingo High School alma mater.